huge.
It's over 16,000 square feet. Thousands of people have been in here, but they didn't know they were actually in a part of the bunker. This room was used for exhibits, medical exhibits, book exhibits, parties.
When the time came that the government had to continue, what did this room become?
The room would have been subdivided into 24 offices for the support staff of Congress.
I mean, there are hospitals, dormitories, there's even a crematorium. There are places for families and aides to stay.
Now, how is it possible that this place was kept a secret without the hotel employees and people of the town knowing about it?
I, like so many others, had heard for years that there was something here.
So you were working here while the bunker was still a secret?
Yes.
Did you ever see somebody walking through the hotel, suspicious-looking character, and think he must be on his way to the secret facilities?
We did wonder about some of those television repairmen.
So that was the cover. All these people, the television repair crews came in, and literally they were the ones working on this facility.
Now we know they were spending 85% of their time on shelter management.
This whole thing sounds like a page from a spy novel. And if the government can construct a facility of this size in plain sight and have it be completely covered up, I guess there's a possibility that in Dulce, New Mexico, something similar on a much larger scale could happen, given it's in the middle of nowhere.
When did you first learn, for real, what this was?
The day the article appeared in the Washington Post magazine.
Until the Washington Post broke the story, nobody knew that this hotel was a cover for an underground facility, literally a bunker, to house the legislative branch of government in time of war.
The last government truck left July 31st, 1995.
So that's 3 years it might have taken to actually build a facility to replace this.
Unless there were other facilities
already in existence.
Yeah, exactly. When you visit a place like Greenbrier with this extensive facility that was constructed under the very eyes of the people working here, it tells me that of course you could have a Dulce.
Bill has a point that it's very incredible that this kind of facility can be built right in front of the public eye.
We know that this underground facility is 112,000 square feet. And based on what we learned about the secret base in Dulce, and some calculations that I did, I actually learned that it could be over 3,000 times the size of a facility at Greenbrier. We know that Greenbrier took 3 years to build, so it could have taken 10 years, decades, to construct any kind of base at Dulce. And there's not even any evidence that it was ever built in the first place.
The people who built Dulce could have built it for a variety of reasons, with a variety of cover stories. And where are they building it? On reservation land. Nobody's going to question that. And even if they did, they'd be told to shut up.
I mean, Homo sapiens were capable of incredible things. If we really put our mind to it, if engineers really wanted to build a base under Archuleta Mesa and keep it a secret, we have the technology to do that. It could be done.
Here's what I believe. We've spoken to firsthand witnesses, eyewitnesses, who've seen craft hovering over the Archuleta Mesa. We've spoken to people who've talked about cattle mutilations, who've actually seen black helicopters hovering over the countryside. We've seen actual photos of the strangest kind of entity I've ever seen in my entire life. A fetus in the womb of a mutilated cow, but it's not a cow fetus. What is it? Is there some strange genetic experimentation going on in Archuleta? Is there interbreeding of species going on and incubation inside cows, which is why they're mutilating these cattle? If you don't believe that all this can go on under the very eyes of an entire population, we went to Greenbrier in West Virginia, a completely undisclosed, top secret, underground base constructed right before the very eyes of hundreds of hotel guests and workers. Greenbrier proves that underground secret bases are not just a possibility, but probably an absolute reality.